Hi, Mandy.
How are you? Rusev, how are you? Lana. Pretty. Oh,
those are some cool sunglasses.
Thank you. I'm like, I love them. Good job on Monday, by the way.
Actually, question. Carmella went up to her and said that I took her off of live events, and I had to say that it was actually you that said that.
Can we clarify what happened? Can I say something without you interrupting?
She interrupts me all the time.
I openly said that ambitiously, the suggestion that you made turned into this situation where now Carmella's not on the show wrestling. She's there just like in presence.
Hey.
And now Lana, you need to take a nap and you need to settle down.
All right, drama queen, you got a wedgie.
Are you going upstairs? Hello.
It's kind of funny that Natty and Lana are fighting every 5 seconds. One minute they're friends, one minute they hate each other.
Goodbye.
I can understand. Lana is quite a lot to handle. Crazy hurricane freaking Lana. So what about this match?
I will officially have the most pay-per-view matches of any woman in the history of WWE. That's why I feel like match is so big that if I don't win it, I don't think I'm ever going to have a chance to win the championship ever again.
First of all, one step in front of the other.
I know.
Don't get like you're totally putting the cart before the horse.
As far as Lana goes, she's just got in my head talking about me not being able to speak.
Why are you letting that get in your head?
I don't know. Everything we do in WWE is subject to opinion. Maybe Lana's right. Maybe my voice is too deep, or maybe my inflections aren't right. So I'm literally hired a vocal coach.
Really?
For some reason now, every time I cut a promo, every time I do a backstage interview, I'm like, I don't feel like I can do this.
I feel like it's your time. I think you freaking earned it and deserve it.
I just feel like I'm so nervous.